Let's now consider time zones and how that relates to Earth's rotation, and then flying planes and calling up friends and so on the other side of the world. We all know that there's 24 hours in a day, and we know that there's 360 degrees in a circle, and that's, for example, the circumference of an hour, circumference of the Earth. So 1 hour should therefore be every 15 degrees. So the time it takes for 15 degrees of the Earth to rotate, an hour would have passed. So we calculate time zones in relation to the prime meridian, which is in Greenwich in London in England. So we say that the time in Greenwich is the Greenwich Mean Time. Now, the international dateline is 180 degrees from the Greenwich Meridian. So east of the line is 24 hours different to west of the line of the international dateline. So they're a day apart pretty well. 15 degrees in longitude is 1 hour time difference. Although, because we have political boundaries in different states and countries, it doesn't always work. Now, that also works out to be 1 degree of longitude is about 4 minutes in time difference. Let's consider this issue here. Now, Australia is 2,511 miles wide, Canada is 3,402 miles wide, and China is 2,193 miles wide. Now, Australia has three time zones. China has five, sorry, Canada has five, and China has one. So, why is that the difference? Have a look at this. So, Australia, 2,500, and it's got three zones, whereas Canada, 3,000, and it's got more. Well, that makes sense. But China is just a little bit different. It's only got one time zone. So what's happening here? So Canada is further from the equator than Australia, which means the meridians of the longitude are closer together. China's government has decreed also that the whole country will be one time zone. So that's a political thing there. Let's think about this one. On the 28th of February 2016, Jill turned 21. 2 days later, her older brother Bill turned 21. How is that possible if they are born 10 minutes apart? Well, Jill and Bill were born on a ship as across the international dateline. Bill was born on the 1st of March on the west of the line. The boat crossed on the east of the line. By the time Jill was born, she was born on the 28th of Feb. So 2016 was a leap year, so their birthdays were 2 days apart. Let's have a look at a worked example. So Bundaberg is 10 hours ahead of GMT. So you can also say 10 times 15 degrees, 150 degrees. So around 150 degrees or thereabouts in front or east of London. Now Auckland is 12 hours ahead, so it's pretty well close to the international dateline. If it's 9 a.m. in Bundaberg, what time is it in Auckland? Well, we know the time difference is GMT plus 12 and GMT plus 10. So it's just positive 12 minus positive 10, which should be 2 hours apart. So Auckland is 2 hours ahead of Bundaberg. So we said that if it's 9 a.m. in Bundaberg, it should be 2 hours ahead in Auckland, and that makes it 11 o'clock. Let's now consider a time difference when we're on opposite sides of the GMT or the prime meridian. So we have Bundaberg, which is a GMT plus 10, and Los Angeles, which is a GMT of minus 7. Let's read through it and talk about it. So Bundaberg is GMT plus 10, while Los Angeles is GMT minus 7. If it's 9 a.m. in Bundaberg, what time is it in Los Angeles? Well, let's consider the time difference first of all. So we know that Bundaberg is plus 10. We know that LA is minus 7. So we've gone 10 and then 7. We've gone a total of 17 hours difference in time. So Los Angeles is 17 hours behind Bundaberg. Now, what is the time in LA when it's 9 a.m. in Bundaberg? Well, we need to say 9 a.m. take away 17 hours. Now, I like to break this 17 hours up, taking it down to a midnight sort of thing, and then taking it down further. So I'll say 9 a.m. take 9 hours to take it to midnight. Now, 17 take 9 is 8. So what we're really saying then is 9 a.m. take 9 to take it to midnight, take another 8 hours. So midnight take 8 hours is 4 p.m. on the previous day. Let's have a look at this one. What should be the time difference between Bundaberg and Shanghai? Now we're looking at longitude, and we've said two things. We've said that 15 degrees per hour, or I think we said 1 degree is 4 minutes. So let's consider the difference in the angular difference. So 155 take 120, well that's 35 degrees. So 35 degrees times 4 minutes per degree, that should give us 140 minutes. It should be about 2 hours and 20 minutes difference. Now let's have a look at a couple of others. Rio is GMT minus 3, Vancouver is GMT minus 7. So there are 4 hours difference. Vancouver is 4 hours behind Rio. So 4. If it is 2 a.m. in Rio, what time is it in Vancouver? So what do we need to do? We need to go backwards 4. So 2 a.m. take 2 down to midnight, and then we take another 2, so it should be 10 p.m. on the previous day. Now, what should be the time difference between Cairo and Los Angeles? So we can look at this, and we've said that there are 15 degrees per hour. So how many degrees have we traveled? We are thinking 30. We've crossed GMT plus that, so it's 150. So 150 divided by 15, that's a nice even 10 hours time difference, and that's quite nice. There it is there. Your work now is page 231, and that's exercise 6C.